Does swimming cause muscle imbalances in the shoulder? Swimming techniques are very heavy on internal rotation loads. I can speak from experience, as when I tore my subscapularis tendon, it really hindered my ability to load on all of the strokes, especially breaststroke and backstroke. This was because of the increased internal rotation load on these two strokes versus front crawl and butterfly, and the fact that subscapularis internally rotates the shoulder. So what does the evidence say about this subject? Batalha et al. 2014 tested the strength balance between internal and external rotation in the shoulders of 27 young male swimmers, which was the experimental group, and 22 male students who were not involved in swim training. This was the control group. They tested both groups at the start of the swimming season and then again at 16 weeks of training. Swimmers' strength in both areas increased, especially on the internal rotators, which significantly increased in strength. This created a different ratio of internal to external rotation strength. The same imbalances were also found in another study by Ramsey et al. 2004. So if you want to maintain the ratio of strength between the internal and external rotators, then you need to do something more than just swim. So you need to add some external rotation by shoulder exercises to compensate for this imbalance. So the next question that needs answering is, does an imbalance of internal to external rotation strength increase your risk of injury? Anyway, stay tuned for the next video on swimming. So if you like this video, please subscribe, leave a comment, and give us a thumbs up, and we'll see you next time.